Doug Howie, he's in the thick of doing maintenance on his Model T. Ken, what are you working on this morning?
Doing a little change, getting ready for another 500 miles or so.
Okay.
And I want plenty up front, too. I've seen some of you guys in Model T.
This is Kirk Hill and his Model T.
This is Miss Rosemary. I've had Miss Rosemary since 1987. Taking really good care of it over the years. I've kept it all original, except that I've had to paint it a couple times, rebuild the engine a couple times. It has, the only thing it's not making for me is the carburetor, which I switched out the NH, which works much better. I think everybody goes with the NH.
Everybody runs the NH carburetors. They like them a lot better. Okay.
Yeah, they're indestructible.
Okay, that's a good way of putting it.
The only trouble I really had on this is a brand new radiator I got built for me, because I knew it was going to take some heat. And it's been doing great. It doesn't even gurgle. But on the first day, caught a rock in the radiator.
And where was that?
Back here.
Okay, so how'd you end up repairing it?
Well, Scott, we were trying to figure out what to do. It was just spewing water right out the front. Reading and I were riding along, and I said, I smelled antifreeze. We need to check. And I looked all in the hood, couldn't find that one in front. And there's this stream of water. Brand new radiator, Scott showed up, and we talked about it. I'd been trying to put a stick in it. And he said, what about a toothpick? So we stuck a toothpick in it, and the toothpick got me there the rest of the day. I guess it swelled when it got on me. And when we got there, we decided that we would put some silicone rubber around it to keep the toothpick. And the guy that built the radiator, I called him, he said, do not take that toothpick out. He said, leave it in there. And so, and I mean, it's not even leaking now, but yeah. I'm going to take it back to him to fix it, because he did a really good job.
Well, it looks like it's held up since day one, and we're doing well. We're on day 15 now, so
yeah,
great.
But it's been great. I've loved it. We're running high-speed gears, no ruts, no secondary transmission, so I have to run the hills. I would like everybody to know that when I go by, I'm not trying to be something like you. I can't be behind somebody going slow. If I get behind somebody going slow,
you got to make a mad dash for the hills. That's right.
Fast and come back up.
Okay.
So I run the hills. And it's been doing great. Of course, the car is real light.
Yes.
But it's a great little car. It's our favorite little car.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Yeah.
How are you?
Spraying on the windows.
Spraying on the windows. You having fun in there? This is Erica and Ryan Haugie, and they're going to tell us about their Model T.
So, we got it 2 years ago. Uncle Doug helped us find it.
That's a nice touch.
Yeah. In order to get it roadworthy, of course we've got a new engine in here, rebuilt the transmission, and ruxed the rear end. These were all rotted out, so I had to replace these front two wood pillars both sides, along with the head visor and the board underneath the cowl. They redid the roof, they put 2x6s on the top. Very heavy, so I bought a wood kit for the top, redid the whole wood kit, making it probably 50 pounds lighter, which is crucial. And during that time, we redid all the interior upholstery, Erica did all that sewing, and we insulated the top so the heat wouldn't penetrate through going through Kansas. It worked great. Redid the top and just various pieces. Piece of safety glass we had to add. Other than that, it was just a quick crank up start and we were ready to go.
Are you enjoying the trip?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
The boys are having fun.
The boys are having fun?
Yep.
They seem to be.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for sharing it.
As you can see, this is what they do when the car's not running. They're in it, hanging out. So they obviously are very comfortable and love it.
Well, safe travels to the four of you.
Thank you very much.
Was leaking this morning when we checked it. Where I patched it, it wasn't leaking, but the drain tube was leaking.
This is Billy McGuire and his Model T with the infamous pink wire wheels.
This car is a car that I've had since I was 10 years old. I fell in love with it when I was 8. My uncle said he'd give it to me as long as I could take it apart and put it back together again. Being the son of a surgeon who didn't know anything about mechanics, the only way I was going to learn how to do that is to learn how to read out of the Ford repair manual. When I was 10 years old, my uncle gave the car to me for a Christmas present because I had demonstrated to him that I could take it apart and put it back together again. So I've had this car since I was 10 years old, which makes I've had it for 43 years. And it's been, I wouldn't say restored, I would say it's been fixed up and fixed up and fixed up over again. It's not showy, but it sure is fun and I love it because it's been my first love car forever. When I was improving it over the years, over the many fix-ups, I had gotten these wire wheels to replace the wooden artillery wheels, and I showed up at home and I asked my twin daughters, who were 8 at the time, and at that time my whole family was touring every summer with the car at different locations on our MTFCI annual tours. I said, what color do you want me to get the new wire wheels painted? Well, they said pink, hot pink. Well, the moral of the story is never ask a woman's advice if you're not willing to take the answer. So I've had pink wheels ever since my 8-year-old twin daughter said hot pink. I love the car, drive the snot out of the car, and am never hesitant to take it anywhere, anytime, and it's just a good old fun flitter.
So glad you enjoyed it. And this is your second time going cross country?
It's my second time going across country. First time for my new bride, Meredith, and she's enjoying the scenes and the sights, and we're just having a great time.
Well, you have a great day today. Thank you.